Leia here from leiaforsci.com/MCAT, and in this video I'm going to show you a trick for how to raise decimals to an exponent without using a calculator. On the MCAT you're not allowed to use a calculator, but you will be asked to solve mathematical problems. Let's say you find yourself with an example, 0.3 squared. How do you solve this without a calculator and quickly so that it doesn't waste time on your exam? If you think about what we're looking at, 0.3 squared means that we have the number 0.3 times 0.3. This is how you're not going to do it on the MCAT. This method wastes too much time. The other way to look at it is to say, if we have 0.3 times 0.3, let's multiply 3 times 3, that will give me 9, and then use the decimal trick. To make this into a whole number, I have to multiply by 10 and multiply by 10. That means I just multiplied by 10 times 10, which is really times 100, to give me the answer of 9. And now I have to undo that by moving the decimal back 2 spaces, dividing by 100. This refers to the decimal trick that I covered earlier in this MCAT math series, for an answer of 0.09. This process is a little tedious, and this is a relatively simple problem. As the decimals and the exponents get more complex, you'll need a simpler method because this will take too long. So let me show you the shortcut. We're going to apply the same method as the last one, but in a simpler way so that you rush through it. First thing we do is take the exponent onto the number itself. In this case, we have 3 squared, which gives me 9. And then we figure out quickly how many decimal spaces we need to move to the right or the left. Since we're dealing with numbers less than 1, the decimals will be moving to the left. What you want to do is ask yourself, how many decimal spaces do I need to move the number to the right so that I get a whole number? In this case, 0.3 requires 1 decimal space to the right to give me a whole number. That's 1 space times the number of exponents we have. In this case, it's 2. 1 times 2 is 2. That means moving the decimal twice to the right gives me whole numbers. So for the answer, I have to move it back twice to the left, and that gives me 0.09. Notice that this is exactly what we did the long way. We moved it twice to the right and then unmoved it by moving it twice to the left, but without actually taking the time to write it all out. This trick saves you even more time when the numbers are more complex. For example, if I have 0.03 squared, let's do the same thing. We square the number itself. 3 times 3 is 9, and then count the decimal spaces. 2 spaces, times 2 for the power. So we have 2 times 2, 4 decimal spaces. Back to the left, 1, 2, 3, 4. For an answer that is 0.0009. You may want to put this into scientific notation. In this case, we'll have 9 times 10 to the minus 1, 2, 3, 4. Or, if you got a whole number, just think of it this way. We started with a number 9. We know that we need to move 2 decimal spaces times 2 for the power, which is 4. Isn't moving the decimal back 4 spaces the same as saying times 10 to the minus 4? That's exactly what we get. Let's try one more complex example, where we'll take the number 0.05 and raise it to the 3rd power. Just to remind you, the long way to solve this problem looks something like this. 0.05 times 0.05 times 0.05. This is going to take way too much time for the MCAT, so let's simplify it. We take the exponent onto the number itself. In this case, 5 to the 3rd power is 125. How do I know that? 5 to the 3rd is 5 times 5 times 5. And 5 times 5 is 25, times 5 is 125. If you don't have this memorized, make sure you download my MCAT math cheat sheet and memorize all the equations, all the multiplications, all the decimals, all the fractions. You have to know them, and quickly. Find this entire series, along with the MCAT math practice quiz and cheat sheet, on my website, leiaforsci.com/MCATmath. Now that we have the number 125, let's see what to do about the decimal. We have to move the decimal space twice to the right to get a whole number, that's 2. The power is 3, so we multiply by 3. 2 times 3 is 6, so we have to move the decimal 6 spaces back. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. for an answer that is equal to 0.000125. Again, you probably want to put this into scientific notation, which would be 1.25 times 10 to the minus 1234. Or the faster way is to say that we have 125 times 10 to the minus 6, which is what we got when we figured out how many decimal spaces we need to move back. But this is not proper scientific notation. So we'll move the decimal back 2 spaces, that's divide by 100, and raise this number up 2 spaces times 100. Again, this is another trick covered earlier in this series. And that will give me 1.25 times 10 to the minus 4, which we already predicted. Remember, you are not allowed a calculator on the MCAT, and you do not want to waste precious time on calculations. Make sure you go back and study the entire MCAT Math Without a Calculator series, and then try the practice quiz linked on my website, leahforsci.com/mcatmath.